Alhamdulillah, is I thank them for even considering me for such a prestigious award. And to be honest, I was not expecting it, because in the field of media, when it comes to Muslims, there are a lot, and so many brothers and sisters out there who are doing so like major contributions to the media in general and to the Muslim media in particular. You have to go back to those days. It is on the background of and the backdrop of the 9/11 happened in 2001. At the time, the war on Afghanistan was going on. Then the war in Iraq started 2000, a couple of months actually, a few months before the launch of the channel, less than 1 year and a half actually down the line, the 7/7 in London happened. So you have to take it within that political context. It wasn't a media outlet that is fighting for viewership or for sponsorship or for advertising, for positioning, for ratings. This is where the media usually, where they compete. But as a management, our duty was beyond that. How can we be a voice for Muslims? How can we give guidance to Muslims in these dark times? It was only in the last couple of years that the government came to terms that we are here to stay, and that we are here as a force for good, and that we are contribution to the Muslim life in UK and to the lives of to the wider society as a whole. Is something positive, is something to be encouraged and something to be cherished. If we go 4,000 years back, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded his prophet Abraham to go on top of a hill and call for people to come for Hajj. That's what media does, is advertising, is telling, let people know that you have a product. And the new product is performing Hajj in Mecca. When the TV came, they thought the radio will go. The radio didn't go, but the TV is there. When the social media came, people, they thought, oh, TV is gone. It's not correct. All these mediums of media will always be there. You have to also adapt to new realities. You have to look what people are looking for. It is not the time you put on your TV, whatever you want has gone. You don't decide when I watch a film or a series, you don't decide it anymore. Now it's video on demand. Never fear to embrace what is new. Never have a conservative approach. Have a futuristic approach to what you are doing, because the future is today. And the future is fast coming, and the changes, the pace of changes, the acceleration, if I use the physics terminology, the acceleration in change is getting higher and higher and higher. So we have to adapt to new realities.